A Wellesley High School student will hit the pavement and run in this year's Boston Marathon, but she's not just doing it for herself.
People I hardly know coming up to me and saying, like, oh, I think it's awesome what you're doing.
This week on Inside Wellesley, the story behind Sabina Hartnett's race to the finish line. With the Boston Marathon just weeks away, a Wellesley High School senior is doing everything she can to make sure she's prepared for this year's race.
It's hard some days getting up and getting out when it's, you know, 16 degrees and icy and you have to go do your long run, you know. You get through it and it helps you in the end.
But for Sabina Hartnett, it's not just about crossing the finish line.
So I'm raising money for the Hannah Randolph Memorial Fund and running the marathon in her honor.
Randolph was killed back in 2012 during a tragic skiing accident in Colorado. She was a freshman at WHS, 15 years old.
When Hannah passed away, I had a big realization that there were a lot of things she never got to do, and there were a lot of things I always said, you know, I'll do that later in my life. And I think that later is at some point you just have to say, you know, it's now.
Hartnett has had her sights set on the Boston race for the past 18 years.
A lot of my family has run it. Both my parents have run it. A lot of aunts and uncles, even cousins have run it. And so it's kind of a family tradition for us.
And after last year's bombings, she knew it was time.
So we actually were at the finish. I mean, not directly at the finish. We were about a quarter mile away waiting for him.
Hartnett's dad ran in the 2013 marathon, crossing the finish line about 10 minutes before the two bombs went off.
We had no idea where my dad was, hadn't heard from him. They shut down cell service. So it was a very scary 45 minutes until we saw him.
All the more reason, Hartnett says, to participate this year.
I definitely have a great appreciation for why people want to run this year. And I mean, obviously, I also do, having been there last year.
But getting a number isn't as easy as you may think. You can either qualify or enter for a charity. Since Hartnett knew she wanted to run in Randolph's name, she applied directly to the town of Wellesley. Right now, I'm standing on the marathon's halfway mark. Since Wellesley's on the course, they get a certain amount of numbers to hand out. In November, the Board of Selectmen told Hartnett she was in. All she had to do now was raise the money.
The legal minimum for the Boston Marathon as a charity runner is $4,000, and so my original goal was $6,000. But there was a huge influx of donations, and so I raised my goal to $10,000.
All the money being donated to Randolph's Memorial Fund,
which gives scholarships to kids from Wellesley High who embody a lot of the characteristics that Hannah held very highly, which are, you know, academics, being involved in extracurriculars, arts. She was a musician, and athletics.
A cause Hartnett definitely considers worth running for. For Wellesley Media, I'm Natalie Kaplan.